If you don't want to look like you're checking your email on stage as you have your laptop in Ableton Live up there next to you, then you need to use a MIDI controller. Hey, this is Will Doggett. Today I'm going to show you how I use my MIDI controller and how I map it to control Ableton Live on stage with tracks. So let's get started. Now, previously, we've talked about how to set up your MIDI controller with Live, specifically for live performance, how to connect it, adjust things and preferences. So I've linked to that video below in the description so you can take a look. But today, I want to show you how I use my MIDI controller of choice and the four things that I map to it so that I can have control over Ableton Live. Now, the controller that I love working with and using is a Disaster Area Designs DMC6D. Now, this is a Gen 3, and the big difference between Gen 2 and Gen 3 is the Gen 3 does everything. So the Gen 2, if you can find one used or refurbished, it's going to work great for tracks, but the Gen 3 has a lot of extra control, especially as a guitar player, if you're using a lot of pedals with presets and doing special stuff. Now, one thing I want to show you on this guy is when you get your Gen 3 DMC6D, if you want to use it with Ableton Live, then hold down the D button to enter access mode. You'll see an X show up, and then now this foot pedal is going to function just like a Gen 2 controller, and this is how I typically use it. Now, there's a lot of stuff you could do on this pedal. You could add an additional pedal that has two buttons that allows you to change banks, presets, do all sorts of crazy stuff. But I keep it pretty simple. Again, four main things that I map. Occasionally, I'll also map my songs to select different songs. And if I do that, I use a different bank. So on this pedal, the way it's configured right now is if you hold down one of these buttons, it's gonna change to a separate bank. And so I typically would put that on a different bank and do song 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 if I have that in a set, and I can go higher or lower if needed. But the typical way I use this, again, is four things. So let me show you what those are. So the very first thing, if you're gonna use this on stage, we have to have a play button. So I'm gonna hit Command M, I'm gonna click the play button on this track, and then I'm gonna press the A button, and you'll see it automatically maps. Now if I open up the browser over here to show you Live's MIDI mappings browser, you'll see this is sending down MIDI channel 16, note C-2. So that's play. Now let's do stop. So I'm gonna go to my stop button here, and I'm just gonna press B. So I have this to play, I'm gonna make this stop. Now the two other buttons and functions I use that are essential for me if I'm performing on stage in Ableton Live with tracks is this previous locator button and next locator. That's gonna allow me to jump around my arrangement super easy without having lots of things mapped to a controller. So I'm gonna click the previous locator button and let's map that to C, okay? And then let's click next locator. We'll map that to D. So now I'm gonna press Command M to get out of MIDI map mode. And again, with these four buttons, I have total control over my Ableton Live set. So the first thing I'm gonna do is press play. So let's press A, and you see our Ableton Live set starts. Now if I wanna stop it again, I can press B, but let's keep it going, let's press play. And now I want to jump to somewhere later in the song. So I'm gonna press the D button so that I can jump to one of the next locators and jump as far as I want to within a one measure period because of global quantization, which is set to one bar. So as this is just going, let's just jump anywhere in our song. All right, I'll jump to the B section. One of my favorite reasons for doing this, and again, just using four buttons, is often I'm on stage with a band and we want to repeat the section we're on. What I see people do a lot of times is have a MIDI controller with tons of sections mapped. Occasionally I'll use an iPad with TouchOSC with all my sections available to me. But I need something really simple. I need something that I can quickly go, we need to repeat, I press repeat. Not very smart, I need it to be simple. So if I'm on this section that I'm on right here, this section B, and I know that we want to repeat it, I just wait till the last measure that we're in, and I just hit the repeat button or previous locator button and I jump back. Again, super, super simple. Four buttons, play, stop, previous, and next locator. So what I would encourage you to do is take this concept and apply it to whatever MIDI controller you have. At least start with those four functions, play, stop, previous, and next locator. And then from there, you can add your songs. What I do is I typically map my songs to my computer keyboard, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I have my laptop over to the left or over to the right so that I can select my songs. But I also program my set in a way that I can be very hands-off and just use my MIDI controller, again, to just press play, stop, repeat and skip a section. So if you're interested in using a MIDI controller to perform on stage with, but you're not sure what MIDI controller to get, then head to fromstudiosage.com/gear. Put together a free gear guide that offers suggestions no matter what position, what instrument you're playing on stage, for MIDI controllers, for audio interface, what computer you should get, version of Ableton Live, all sorts of things. Again, completely free, and I want to share that with you so you can get started quickly. So to get that, again, head to fromstudiosage.com/gear. Thanks so much for watching this tutorial, and I will see you next week. Take care. Bye.